Hi there, thanks for joining me. I'm digital artist Aaron Rutten, and in this video, I'm going to be going over the installation, configuration, and different ways you can control the new Wacom Intuos. The old Wacom Bamboos are now the new Wacom Intuos Pen and Touch. This is the small version, and this is the pen that comes with it. It's got some really cool express keys here that you can use to perform different shortcut functions. It's a really nice looking little tablet. I review it in more detail in a separate video, which I will link to in the description here. This video is just going to focus on how to use the tablet and how to get set up with it. So what you should have after you unbox is your tablet, your pen, and your USB cable. You'll also have a driver CD, but I recommend that you download the newest drivers from Wacom's website. So the way that you find those drivers is do a Google search for Intuos drivers, and it should be one of the first links that comes up, drivers for Wacom, from Wacom's website. You click on that link, you'll get to this drivers page, and if you scroll down, you will see some different drivers. You want to look for latest driver for Intuos, and you'll download either the Windows or the Mac version. I'm on a Windows computer, so I downloaded the Windows version. It'll take a minute to download, and then once it's downloaded, go to your downloads folder or wherever you downloaded the file to, and double-click to install the drivers. Now, it'll take a minute to install the drivers, and then it'll want to restart your computer. Go ahead and restart, and then after it's restarted, continue with this. And the next thing that we'll do is we will ensure that our tablet is working properly after the drivers are installed. So I'm going to plug in the USB cable here in the back. You want to make sure that it's going the right way. And there you go, it's plugged in at the top. The express keys go up, and then I'm going to plug this other end into the USB port on my computer. Doesn't really matter which one. And since the drivers are installed, it'll just take a quick second to do its thing with the computer here and recognize the tablet. And momentarily, we should have a functioning tablet. You'll see that this white LED light came on, and what that's showing is that the tablet is powered on, that it's receiving power from your computer. And now it says Wacom tablet device software installed successfully. So if we move our finger on the tablet now, you can see that it's working. It works as a trackpad would on your laptop, if you have a laptop. You can also see that this blue light lights up anytime I touch the pad or if I hover with my pen over the pad. And our pen works by hovering slightly over your tablet, but don't actually touch the tip to the tablet itself, just hover. And when you want to do a mouse click, let's say minimize this window, you tap with your pen. And there you go. You can also tap and hold, and you can move windows around. You can double tap to do a double click. You can use the top button on your pen here to do a right click. And we can configure this in some different ways. So what might be a little confusing about this tablet to begin with is when you're using the trackpad here, it doesn't matter where you really put your finger down on your tablet, you're gonna move your mouse. Let's say if I put my finger here and I move my mouse down, it's just gonna move my mouse down or up. My pen works differently. The pen works in relation to where you are on your tablet. So if my pen is pointed here in the top corner of the tablet, you can see that the cursor moves to the top corner. If I put my pen down here in the bottom left corner, you can see the pen moves down there. So the pen kind of points to the different part of the screen in relation to where it is on the canvas. The trackpad, however, just moves the mouse from wherever it's at. So that might be a little confusing to begin with, but you'll get used to that. So let's configure this tablet a little bit. After your driver installed, what you'll want to do is go to your control panel, That's found here under the Windows menu, Control Panel. And then we'll go to the newly installed Wacom tablet properties. And we get this little window here. So what this is showing us, first of all, is the express keys. And as I mentioned before, there are four express keys that you can use to perform different commands. If you want to configure them to do different keystrokes or clicks, you can go forwards, backwards, pan and scroll, show desktop, all kinds of different commands that you can set these to here. We won't set them quite yet. This is a very important area, this pen tab here. We'll switch to that because your pen has pressure sensitivity, and so if you tend to push down really hard, you might want to set this tip feel a little different versus if you push down really lightly. So I tend to draw really hard and write really hard, so I set this to firm because I find that it gives me the right amount of pressure. And if you push down light or very firm, you'll see you get this little test bar here. You can do the same with your eraser. And you can set some other things like the functions on your pen. Mapping is very important because if you're using two monitors, you have two screens, you may need to set your tablet to only work on one screen, or if you prefer, you could have it to span both screens. You can do that here. You can select just a particular monitor or a portion of the screen or all screens. There's a little Windows Ink option here, and if for some reason you don't like this little bubbling effect that happens when you click, you can turn this off. And I won't do that anymore. I like to keep it off. We'll go to touch options and pointer speed. This is again some ways to kind of configure your touchpad. Standard gestures. If you watch this for a minute, it'll show you some different shortcuts that you can use to navigate and control what you see on screen here. Lots of different ones. And there's your radial menu. Your radial menu you can bring up and it'll just kind of let you select some different commands here. Again, that can be configured as you want it. We can also go to options here, and if there's anything you want to change, you can change it. There's the hover click, which is the default type of click. So if you hold the pen tip close to the tablet and press the side switch to do a right click, that's how you do your right clicks, and I prefer to keep it that way, by hovering. You can also set it to press the side switch and then tap to do a right click, if that's easier. You can change the handedness if you're left-handed or right-handed. I'm right-handed, so I'm going to keep it at right. And there's a couple of little options here. Adjust the pen pressure for compatibility with older applications. If you're using some really, really old versions of Photoshop or other programs, you might want to check this, leave it on. It's all right if you just leave it on anyways, even if you don't know what it does. And wireless tablet battery status. This is only important if you have the wireless upgrade. And this does have a little wireless kit that you can buy for it to upgrade it. So we will go to this little X here just to close out the window to go ahead and apply our settings. And now let's take a look at how this works in Painter. So I'm going to make a new canvas here. And we'll just make sure that everything works. So I'm going to take a brush, a scratchboard pen. I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut of holding Control and Alt and dragging my pen. And let's do some drawing and see here. Now, if I push down really lightly, you can see that I get this thin line, and if I push down really hard, I get a very thick line. That's the pressure sensitivity. And again, if you wanted to play around with the setting a little bit and change it, you can do that in the Control Panel for Wacom. Now, if you want to use the multi-touch gestures, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to go to the Edit menu, and then go to Preferences, and I believe it's under General, and we'll check this Enable Multi-Touch Compatible box here. And now if we go back to our control panel and go to our tablet properties, we can look at this standard gestures page so we can see some of these different things that we can do. We have two fingers. We can swipe left and right to navigate, so let's try that. And we can rotate our page, zoom in, zoom out. Pretty cool feature, actually. And then we can draw a little bit more, zoom in a little bit more, rotate, and draw. And if we want to reset our page, we can just double click the rotate page tool. If we want to zoom back to 100%, just take our magnifier and click on this 100% button here. Now, one last thing to mention is there's a wireless kit that you can add to this. Kind of have to take this apart a little bit to install it. There is also, hiding behind this little piece of plastic here, there is a set of three nibs. That's these little plastic pieces here, and those nibs can be replaced. That's the pen tip. These are called nibs, and these will wear down over time. I find that it takes, you know, 6 months to a year to actually wear this down a little bit, so these will last you quite a long time. You won't really need to buy any replacement nibs for a while. This Intuos is available in a slightly larger size, and it is also available in the upgrade that is known as the Intuos Pro, which can be bigger and has some different express keys and functions that are on the side. It also comes with a wireless accessory included. So anyways, I hope that answers your questions about how to configure and install the Intuos and then get started with it. If you have any questions, feel free to comment on this video. And if you found this information useful, take a quick second to like this video or share it on YouTube or Facebook, and that'll make it easier for other artists out there to find this information. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for my next video.